When we think of history, AI is not the first image that comes to mind. The history and evolution of car design has always been shaped by technology. Now, it's intelligence that will define the future of that experience. Okay, Ned, we're here at the Heritage Hub, and I feel a little bit more Italian just sitting among these cars. What is this place?
This is a time capsule of everything that we have built over the last 100 years and more. I mean, this is where we store our vehicles from Italian brands, from Fiat and Alfa Romeo and Maserati and Lancia. I mean, what you see here is the history of amazing development of our Italian brands. This is the place where we come to inspire ourselves and just sometimes tap ourselves on the shoulder and say, wow, we did some amazing things.
Yeah. Now let's look a little bit to the future. How do you think this heritage impacts the in-cabin experience and its relative increased importance to the consumer?
It's a great question. I think what you see here, what you observe here, most of observation is the simplicity and utility. And I think the design being the utility of function is something that you can see, historically what we have done here in these brands. And I think, for some period of time in the automotive industry, we disconnected from it. Yeah. I think we inside the vehicle, we just added so many things that customers actually, the drivers don't care about nor enjoy it. And I think going back to that sort of, very simple yet intuitive design inside the cabin is where we after. Going back to basics, if you will, with a new twist.
Yeah, I think it's interesting if you look at interior designs where pre-digitalization, they actually get very, very good. So 60s, 70s, 80s are peaking. And then they really start getting bad. And I think a lot of the reasons they start getting bad is from the requirements of, hey, we're going to build this car in 2 or 3 years.
Right.
You basically freeze. And then by the time the digital experience comes out 3, 4, 5 years later, on day one, it's already dated. And so part of this collaboration is how can we create an environment, a platform where design can continuously be updated and the interface can continuously be tweaked all the way as you get into production. And that's taking a little bit of an inspiration from consumer electronics because there's a ongoing refresh experience there. How do you balance, though, that flexibility all the way to the fact that you have 14 brands and they all have, very distinct experiences?
Yeah, a couple of things. When you look at the history of design, you mentioned, there's the cluster and the radio and the buttons and inputs and everything was very disjoint. And so you would sometimes even, split the sort of how you design the cluster.
HVAC is different from the radio, which is different from,
Exactly. So you had a lot of these inputs, a lot of controls that had their own,
supply chain and suppliers.
And a life of their own. And then in the process of development, you would exchange some components, but not others. So you had very disjoint experience. So, putting everything together into something that's very meaningful and then enjoying the sort of freshness of it is what we're after. And that's what we're working with you to essentially create exactly that, simple, yet always fresh, always intuitive.
Yeah, so basically separate a little bit of the pixels from all the underlying infrastructure so you get the flexibility across brands and across vehicles, but you're not rebuilding everything from every single car for every single platform.
I think, having a 14 brands has, lots of challenges and every, cabin, every experience is a little bit different. When you go to, one brand sort of OEM solution, it's easier to just have that, but, it's our heritage. But abstracting the sort of a platform, yet allowing the brands to have their own life, their own identity, it's critically important to us.
How do you think about that tension between, you have certain situations where you have a projection of a phone into the vehicle. And that actually is a, maybe a much worse brand experience than, let's say, you know, what the OEM wants.
It's complicated. It's a complicated question. It's not an easy question. You know, my focus is give the customers the best kind of experience that they want to have in the car. So that to be a phone experience, let it be. So yeah. if our experience is not good enough or better than the phone experience,
then
they should have that experience. Yeah. So the goal here really is what we build to be as good and better than the phone experience, projected phone experience. And I think it's a tall order to create that, because, you know, the sort of continuity of the phone in a cabin is just a natural native sort of thing. And people are now trained on that. Nevertheless, we spend a lot of money and a lot of time on the big screens and the software and things like that, where we have to figure out what does it mean to us? And how do we generate the value for the customer so they can stay on that screen without saying, well, you cannot use your phone inside the vehicle, which I think is a wrong thing to do.
Yeah, there's anytime you push a viewpoint on a consumer, they're going to react in a negative way. So you have to be led by the consumer. But there is a lot of, I mean, you have OEMs who don't allow any of that. And you, as long as that interior experience is good, then I think you know you don't have that push-pull from consumers. And so I think the focus really ends up being, how do you make that interior experience to be really intuitive? And speaking of intuitive, as you look forward into the next 5, 10, 15 years of interior experiences, where do you think AI ends up being in those cabins? And where do you think is the big impact there?
I think from an AI perspective, I think the more, you know, there's this obviously collaborative agent that's going to exist, you know, voice first, modality, followed by the touch and twist and turn and those sort of things will be there. It's already here and it's going to get immensely improved. But I think there is an ambient element of computing AI that's going to make a big difference.
It's a promptless experience.
It's a promptless, intuitive, contextual experience that I think is going to make a big difference with the AI. Now, to do that, you need a lot of context, you need a lot of data, you need a sort of that intuition that then the cabin needs to develop that's particular to you and to me and to, you know, it needs to recognize that, you know, we're driving alone or there's a friend or a family. And so when you think about what all needs to happen inside the cabin for that sort of agent or ambient compute to create a magic experience, there is a lot to be done, but it will happen.
Yeah,
and I want to get there first.
Yeah. And so we're working together basically to provide a platform that allows you guys to work on the actual differentiated stuff rather than just a
platform. Exactly. So working with you and collaborating with you and with your developers, with your designers as well, to build an abstract then allow us to generate the kind of experience we think our brands deserve and our customers deserve is what we're really excited about.
Basic question, what's a brand?
It's experience. I think for us is what kind of experience do we deliver to the set of customers, targeted customers, that
and how buy these how do you cars. Strengthen a brand and how do you weaken a brand?
By capabilities. I think this is where we differentiate our brand. So for example, on a Ram, trucks. It's very capable truck. Yeah. You know, it can tow, you know, much more than any other truck in the segment. Jeep is the most capable vehicle. It still is you know, some of our Jeeps, like a Grand Cherokee and a Wrangler, are Trail 10 rated. And, you know, there's a lot of wannabes out there that have that sort of a look and muscle, but try to take them to a truck somewhere on a mountain somewhere, and they're going to get stuck at the trail very early on, and Jeep's going to be just going. If you look at what Panda stands for, simplicity, utility, you know, there's a bunch of these videos where you have a Panda going with the Land Rover up the hill, and Land Rover gets stuck in the mud, and the Panda just keeps on, you know, keeps on going. And so the utility and that we deliver with our vehicles, with our brands, is unsurpassed, and that's what the brand is really for us. And then we have some luxury brands like premium brands like a Maserati and Alfa Romeo. These are more luxurious sports brands and so forth.
Do you think the experience for the consumer between not only brands, between regions changes very significantly, or do you think it's similar?
It's different. I think the experience is different. I mean, you have American roads, you have American parking,
American drivers,
American garage. You know, it's a different vehicle, different need. And then you have a European, and even in Europe, it's different. You go from a Germany to France to Italy, you have a completely different experience. And I think that that's what we're really good at. Differentiating on those experiences.
Could you ever imagine that within an individual vehicle or brand that the experience slightly changes between if you're in the U.S. versus you're in Europe?
Yeah. We do that. I mean, we do that just simply because we have to in some cases.
For regulatory reasons.
Different regulatory, requirements, we need to do that. But there's some specific, it's like languages, for example, the jokes that an entertainment that we want to bring into the vehicles change because, some are more sensitive than the others, right? So there's a certain level of experience that do change.
Let's talk a little bit about what is the AI experience in the future inside the vehicle. Paint a picture of what you think that future AI experience looks like inside the vehicle.
I think, as mentioned before, the agent modality or voice modality it will be just natural.
Dominant
and natural. So there will be no more sort of, hey, Alexa, Google, Siri type of thing where we have a broken experience. It will just natural with a Jeep, do this or that. It will just happen, and it will be, I would say, contextual. So you're going to carry the context, just like you see some of the systems today where I can have a conversation with my vehicle for the ride the next couple of days. It will remember the context of what I was doing, and it will then suggest certain things that today we cannot do that. We can do prompts and things like that, but the context and the memory that the vehicle is going to have, and that context is going to carry for the rest of your day, it's going to be natural. Beyond that, I think the intuitive set of capabilities and experience that the vehicle is going to bring. So, for example, even to all the way to safety areas where you're going to have, you're going to drive down the road and the vehicle and say, well, you should not go down this road. You probably want to make a left over here and go down
this other road.
So it would be like a friend.
Yeah.
Customers can decide or the drivers can decide, well, I'm going to have this feature. I don't want to have this feature. I don't want to have the sort of a intrusive thing. We're quite lonely in a car when we drive, for 15 minutes a day. So having somebody there to be present when you wanted to be present, to read your book or to have fun and to collaborate on certain things, it's going to be there. Productivity is going to be a big part. Today, we have this sort of idea of how do you become productive in a vehicle. And so I'm productive by making a lot of calls.
Yeah.
I accept calls and I make a lot of calls. I call you, I call a bunch of people while I'm driving, so I don't want to lose their time. Yeah. Or I'm entertained or informed. I listen to books or what have you. I think with the agent technology, I think productivity is going to dramatically improve.
Yeah, Applied, our mission is to accelerate the adoption of safe and intelligent machines, and specifically in an intelligent cabin. Our view is we really want to move from the main interaction is us taking care of the car to the other way around, where the main interaction is the car taking care of us. So it knows what is on your schedule and what's in your calendar, what your mental state is, how tired you are. And that type of teaming, I think, is going to be really the future of that human-machine combination.
I agree. I think that interaction between a machine and a human, the car and a human, is going to be very different. In the future, it's going to be more collaborative, and I can't wait to get to a state where that machine really takes care of me while I'm driving, whether I'm driving or whether eventually machine takes over, drives. But yes, from a just that sort of cabin experience, I wanna see that happen really soon. It will happen.
And we're gonna work together to make it happen. So I think all the viewers want to know, when are we going to get this in the hands of consumers?
super. Yeah. Now you're pushing it. It's confidential. It's coming soon. We're going to tell them together.
All right. Thank you.